Welcome back to the Creative Marketing Show. I'm really excited to dive in today. This is a little bit of a different episode than what I'm used to, but I wanted to shake things up a bit. And I find that there's so much power in learning while someone else is going through the motions. And so what I did a couple weeks ago is I pitched it inside my community as well as through my emails that if anyone was interested in being a guest on the show and have kind of a fast fire one-on-one audit, whether it relates to their social media, their content, and to come prepared with a few questions so that we could walk through it. I find that the more that we can have conversations, that's where we get these aha moments. So my hope is that through these episodes that are going to be similar, there are a few coming up like this, that you'll also have some key takeaways that you can implement into your own business, because these are real business owners with real questions. And so you never know, this might apply to you as well. And to kick things off, I'm excited to have my first guest, Marcia Cumming. She is an independent travel advisor with Magical Vacation Planner. She books Disney, Universal Studios, all the major cruise lines, all-inclusive resorts, Europe, Hawaii, and even domestic travel. And so we're going to dive through a little bit of her social media to help grow her following and make sure that she's targeting, you know, the right people in her business. So I'm so excited. Let's get this going. Hey, I'm Angela Doyon, and this is the Creative Marketing Show, the podcast for ambitious women in business looking to cut the BS, stop dancing for likes, and learn to create honest and genuine marketing strategies that don't cause burnout and overwhelm. Think of me as one of your friends that's here to support you and cheer you on while keeping you up to date with all the latest marketing trends and inspired actions you can start to implement into your business. Let's dive into a new episode. So, hi, Marcia. Welcome.
Thank you. Hi, Ange. How are you doing?
I'm awesome. I'm so happy to have this conversation. You were actually one of the first who said, oh, I'm interested in that, to have this kind of sit down and conversation, get some clarity or some questions answered. So you're like number one. This is our first one. So I'm excited.
So I am excited too. I've been following you for a long time and I just love everything that you offer and everything you do. So I'm really, really thrilled to be here and to do a little one-on-one.
I appreciate that. Honestly, it's one of my favorite things to do. There's nothing serious. I'm not going to tear anything apart. Don't be scared. It's just, I hope that, you know, through kind of reviewing this and getting some answers for you and maybe some creative ideas that can really spark. I know, you know, that being a member inside the community, the creative marketing membership. So you know how I roll. So it's supposed to be fun. But before we start, can you just tell me a little bit more about yourself and where you're from and what you do?
Absolutely. So my name is Marcia Cumming and I'm an independent travel advisor with Magical Vacation Planner. So you'll find me on social media as Magical Vacation Planner by Marcia. I love to travel. I started to travel when I was in my teens with my parents. And it was just a bug that I got at a very young age. And people would come to me all the time and say, ask me for travel tips. And I was like, one day I said to my husband, I could do this. And he's like, yes, you could. And so I applied for the position and I was hired and I love it. But I'm married. I have three grown children. Mm-hmm. I'm going to be a grandmother in September. So yes, I'm super excited. I'll get to do Disney all over again. With
oh yeah, for sure. That's so exciting.
Yes. We dragged our kids all through Disney when they were little and they loved it. And now as adults, they see it from a totally different perspective, but now they'll get to go back as aunts, uncles, parents, and it'll be a totally different experience.
I love that. The first time I went to Disney World in Orlando, I was 25 years old. And I went on my birthday with my boyfriend, now husband. Yes. And I have to tell you, I cried like a little baby. It was the most magical place, especially on your birthday. I was a grown woman and I wore the big button that said, absolutely, happy birthday, Angie. And everybody said happy birthday. So yeah, if you want to feel really freaking special, go there on your birthday.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I love Disney, even as an adult. Like you said, it's just magical. There's just something about walking down Main Street USA and the music and the people. And it really, truly is magical. So if you've never experienced it, you need to. And if you have, you need to experience it all over again.
And if you need some help making those plans, we know who to talk to.
Absolutely. I'm the girl. Absolutely. Absolutely. And we do so much more than Disney. The company started off as primarily focusing on Disney, right, but over the years, you know, we do Universal. So if you're a huge Harry Potter fan, we gotcha. Yeah. Yes, which I love Harry Potter. We do all the major cruise lines. We do all inclusives all around the world. We do Europe, we do Asia, we do Hawaii, we do domestic travel here within the United States.
Right.
You guys are considered international, but I can still help you with Canada too.
I love that we're still considered international. I'll take
Yeah.
it. Makes us feel a little exotic.
Exactly. A little glamorous, a little luxury travel there across the border.
Totally, totally. So then when it comes to marketing, I know you had a few questions that you had kind of submitted. What's the overall, like, where could we start? What is something that you're like, okay, this is where I'm kind of hitting a roadblock. We know about your industry and who you're serving, and we've talked a little bit more about, we talked about your kind of avatar. It's a lot of, correct me if I'm wrong, but like a lot of the moms making the plans, probably between the ages of 30 to 50. Is that still kind of what we're
Yes,
working with?
yes.
Okay. So when it comes to growing this business, what's the biggest thing that I can help you with right now?
So one of the biggest things I struggle with right now is my followers on Instagram,
Okay.
even on Facebook and my different social media platforms, but it's just followers. My numbers, and I know we talk about it's not all about the number, it's about your content. But the more people that will follow me, the more word of mouth, the more shares.
Yes.
And that really is how my business has grown to this point, is through referrals and word of mouth. But I want to be able to write engaging content that people enjoy, they find useful. They say, hey, I like what she's offering. I want to follow her. And so that I become the authority for them. Because here's the thing people don't realize, when you book through Magical Vacation Planner, we don't charge a fee. All of our services are free. So there,
Oh.
so yes, and that's huge. And that's one thing we talk about. You book the service yourself, or I book it, and we'll just work with Disney as one of our big vendors. It's
Yeah.
the same price. The difference is you're paying for a service you're not getting, and that's me as your concierge travel advisor. I've been to Disney. I go to Disney multiple times a year. I'm
Right.
up on what's going on with the changes. So when you're trying to figure out what is Genie, what's Genie Plus, how does it work? As your travel advisor, I'm going to walk you through it. We're going to, if you're local, we're going to meet as many times as you need to. I'm going to talk to you if you're, and that's the thing, if you're in California, we can FaceTime, we can talk on the phone, we can text,
Right.
but I will make sure that when you hit the ground running at Disney, you'll feel comfortable, confident, and you know you're going to maximize your time there. And that's not just Disney. Universal, on the cruises, all inclusives, wherever you're traveling to, you should feel comfortable that you know what you're doing when you are feet on the
Okay. So I'm really glad we're recording because what you
ground.
have just shared is your Instagram bio to start.
Okay.
Because
Okay.
I know one thing we wanted to talk at, and I've made some notes before we jumped on this call. So I love everything that you just shared there because one of my first notes, I kind of thought we would start at bio and then work into content. And I love knowing that one, it's free because that's usually one of the first questions people ask in terms
Yes.
of any product or service. It could
Yes.
be solve all the problems in the world, but people's minds usually go to, yeah, but how much is it? So that's really good. I didn't realize that. And in terms of your messaging, I really feel like that could stand out because right away you've answered one of the biggest questions a
Yes.
potential customer client could ask you. So saying somewhere in your bio like that it's a free service is pretty important. But I love, so currently, do you mind if I read your current bio out right now?
No, you go for it.
Okay. So for one thing, you're at MV, your yeah, your handle is MVP by Marcia. And then your name, so you know the name portion, you put your name, Marcia Cumming Travel Planner, which is great because it's nice to know that there is a person behind this. This is obviously what you just described as an intimate, like, I'm here to help you. So we want to make sure that there's a person there. So I love that. You have travel planner, which I appreciate because those are keywords. We can also expand. And if you haven't done it in a while, the name portion on Instagram, it actually gives you a lot more characters. They
Okay.
updated that a couple months ago, maybe 6 months ago. When you change your name on Instagram, this is just for everyone listening as well, you can change it twice within a 14-day period. So if you change it once and you're like, crap, I need to change it again, you change it again, you're like, oh, I need to change it again, you got to wait 2 weeks. So I say that as a kind of disclaimer. But I think you've got more room there to really add in more keywords focused on your niche audience. So it could be like travel planner for the busy mom looking to host like the family retreat, or
What was something else? I'd written a little bit more, like personalized experiences for the ultimate family getaway. Just anything that can really speak to, again, now that we've spoken more about your avatar of like that, maybe that 30 to 50, even maybe narrowing that down, woman, mom, if you want to really focus there. And I will say there's nothing wrong with really focusing on that person, her, the mom, who's like, I want this to be a great trip. I want it to be stress-free, hassle-free. I want to know the ins and outs. I want to feel supported and like we're ready to go. Speak to her. So I think somewhere in that name portion, we could kind of maximize that, whether that be just something around the planning for the either the busy mom or the families looking to have a stress-free getaway. That could also go in the bio portion. So, think of, and we can talk more about that inside the community as well, but like that name portion of what are those kind of keywords? Because that's all SEO optimized. So that's going to be great. And people use social media to find, you know, planners and consultants and support coaches, you know, all of that. So I think starting there. And then in the actual bio portion, so currently it's travel planner. Oh, you do have no fees. Excuse me. I missed that, which is kind of interesting because I had looked at this. So no fees, Disney Universal Cruises, all inclusive Europe, Hawaii. So I think we can really maximize this. And I'll go into a few other suggestions and hopefully not to overwhelm at all. But that bio, what you had just described to me as someone who's I'm like right in the middle of your demographic. I'm a mom. I like stress-free vacations. I like things to go smoothly. So right away, while you were explaining that, like, oh, it doesn't cost you anything. And like, I have been there multiple times, so I'm gonna make sure that you feel supported. I can get on a call, like all of that. I'm like, wow, that's amazing. Like that is taking out so much because what do we want to save? Everybody wants to save money. Everybody wants to save time. And what your service offers sounds like you're saving them time and hassle and stress because you're providing them with like everything they need to have a great vacation. You're saving them money because you're planning it out. So there's nothing unexpected where it's like, no, you're going to want this fast pass, or no, you're not going to want to do that. You're not going to want to park here because you're right. Because through your experience. So I almost, because it's you with this, with MVP, but it's you who people are dealing with. There's something I felt like something more personalized. Again, now that I know a little bit more about who you're speaking to, like I had put adding a little bit more why. So like something like, you know, a personalized experience, just take the hassle out of planning your next dream vacation. But I think that's what I initially wrote in my notes. But now the way you described it, and you can go back and listen to this because you described it better because you know who you're speaking to, but almost like I think for you, tailoring one key phrase of like, if I said, why should I work with you? And you can narrow that down to a sentence or two, because you just did that. And right away, I'm like, oh, wow, no hassle, no obligation, really. Like, there's a no fee, and ensure that you're going to get the best out of your time and your money to do what you're supposed to do. And that's enjoy your vacation. Like, even some type of line of like, it shouldn't be a job to take a vacation from your job type of mentality, right? It's supposed to be something enjoyable. So it sounds like to me, like I wrote the word in my notes, experience a lot, like to me, and that comes from, that's kind of two part now that I'm really unraveling this. Your bio could really focus on the experience you have in terms of, and this doesn't have to just correlate just to the bio, because I know we're so limited, but just kind of some real statement of this is why, like the why, save time, save money. And like with over so many years experience, I'm going to ensure that you get the best experience to the multitude of results. And you could, if you can list them, great. If not, I'm not as worried about that because I do think one thing that was also missing is a call to action. So they're on your Instagram, but it's like, where can we take them next? So whether it's clicking the link in bio, whether it's follow along, and what else can they expect here? Because, and that's where I want to get into the content portion. You know, you're offering a service. This is what we're using this account for, to onboard new clients to utilize your services. And that's, so I'm going to kind of segue into that. I wanted to talk about your link in bio, but I'm going to segue into content because I think this is a good way to just keep rolling. for your content, because what I noticed, I went through a little bit of your posts, and I love like the travel trivia and things like that. So for one thing, obviously travel, like it's back to the experience. So we're talking one on part is your experience, the years you've put in, the vacations, the travel you've done as an avid lover of travel. So right away, we're already connected. I'm like, me too. Like, I love it. If I could go, I would love to go anywhere and everywhere. Speaking into that, and then also painting that picture of the experience that person hasn't had yet. So I love using the word storytelling. So you could infuse, like if we call them, you know, we could call them content pillars, themes, whatever you want to talk about, and kind of rotate through for one, like a little bit about you and your experience of working with someone and like how you maybe avoided a crisis, how you maybe like, oh, they had such a great vacation because we went through, you know, I go through this checklist and make sure that it's this and that. So it's talking about your experience, but how you made it a better one. So that also still goes back to you personally. And then also incorporating any kind of customer feedback, testimonials, and images that really like, thank you, Marcia. Oh my gosh. Like, I don't know what I would have done, because that's the kind of FOMO of like, oh gosh, should I be taking this on or do I need help? I love the Thursday travel trivia that you've got going on, but then also like travel tips. And I know we talked about this earlier in a separate call of like safety and like maybe even like packing tips, like all of this stuff that doesn't actually relate to your service, but it's almost, again, when you talk about, because the way Instagram, the way I see that it works is it's really just the stepping stone. It's the, I always use like a dating analysis where Instagram is like your Tinder profile or your dating profile, where it's like, hey, I'm an Aquarius. I love this. Do you like this? Do we have a lot in common? Follow along. So then there's a little match there. But then what we serve in that time is kind of like the first date. That's the content. So it's like, where are we hitting people? And so like that, either that first date can lead into the relationship. And that's where people are like, okay, I'm ready to book with you. So that's serving to onboard. So, and when we talk about growing following, it's like, what can people expect here? Cause if it's always like, well, I don't know, I don't really want to do Disney, or I'm not ready to book anything. I just came back from vacation. So how can we also service them in the off season? So having either travel tips, packing, or what to bring, what to wear, even just showcasing certain destinations and talking about how, you know, in advance you should book for certain trips to have a better experience. What time of year is best to go? Maybe it's a seasonal, like, okay, springtime, here are my recommendations for the top five places to visit in spring, maybe one in summer, one in the fall, and one in the winter, the times to avoid. So that always throughout, people aren't ready to book. You're educating them. We're like, ooh, yeah, I heard somewhere that, you know, you shouldn't book in this time of year to go there because it's actually their winter or whatever that is, or it's the busiest time at Disney. And maybe you know the best time. So it's planting those seeds, right? Some of the other, well, obviously some destination spotlights with something else. I'll pause there. How is that resonating?
Yes, actually, very well, because I started some of those ideas and then I just haven't finished them. And I like that because, like you talked about packing, one of the things I always thought, you know, when you've done the this versus that, as a packing tip, it just sounds silly, but do you roll your clothes or do you fold your clothes?
Right.
And it sounds really silly, but I will fold my clothes going to vacation because they take up more room. And then I roll them coming home because it gives me more room so that I can add more items to my suitcase.
Right. Like that's so helpful. Because remember, you're speaking to people, ideally you want to be speaking to people who eventually will be booking a trip to travel,
right?
Whether it's with you or whether it's not, but you, like, it's almost like being the conduit or resource where it's like, I'm Marcia and I'm like your travel like tip planner. And so like, I even that could be in your bio. Like I offer like practical and tangible tips and advice for the family that's planning their next dream vacation. Need help? You know, let's talk as well. But like people will come to you because it's, again, it's social media is more, I like to look at it as building a relationship. So if someone's like, oh my gosh, that's really cool, I'm going to follow along. She always shares these interesting tips. And the more consistent you can do that, and I am sure you have probably a wealth of like knowledge. And like, to me, just that example right there is like, to fold or to roll, what kind of traveler are you? And like, speak to the traveler. Because that's also something, even if someone's not booking a big trip, but they love to travel or they're going away for the weekend, it's, you're still educating. And then over time, you know, when they go to plan that trip, if they've become someone who has been invested in what you're sharing for free content on social media, and then knowing, wow, it costs me nothing to book a service like this and I can get that extra support. Well, who am I going to go to? I'm going to send Marcia a DM to see what this is all about. So the more consistent of value that you can provide is just going to lend, like you said, to your credibility, and people will be like, yeah, like she's the expert. I want to listen to what she's saying. She's experienced. And then I think also mixing in, like you said, you've been to Disney many a times. Like, I think, again, we're all real people here. Like, showing a picture of your family, like maybe your first time at Disney in a photo, and then like the last time. I mean, like that's so relatable, because we can all remember, even a post of like, have you been to Disney? Like, do you remember your first time at Disney? Like, if you ask me that, I'm like, I remember my first time at Disney, and oh my God. And I know we're focusing on Disney. It's not just Disney, right. I don't know. There's just something pretty magical about it. Quick side note, I just had a thought, because someone sent me this really cute reel, and it was a little girl, she's probably 3 years old, dressed up as Flounder, and she was like following the Little Mermaid around at Disney World, and like, it's okay, I cried it was so freaking cute. I was like, oh my gosh, I wish, oh gosh, it was so adorable. I'm like, I almost was like, okay, I need to have another baby, it's so crazy. I hope my husband's not listening. But even like, there's so much of those reels that are shared as well. So like, things like that, resharing those to your stories, engaging and commenting with that kind of content, looking at who's commenting in those comments as well, because that's where your people are hanging out. Anybody who's like, oh my gosh, that's so cute. Like, so if you want to look and finding new audiences and followers, that's a great place to kind of engage the people who are commenting, following along on those accounts. If there's a way to start any conversations with them, if they're commenting on that, you could also comment on their comments being like, right, so cute. I've been to Disney 25+ times, and like, I never got to wear a Flounder outfit. Like, just the way, like, because those are common people in that area. And if they're clicking like, oh, someone commented, and they click over to yours, and it's like, wow, this person offers a ton of travel advice and like helping me plan or like pack or whatever it is, all these resources, that's the right people, because you know, like that what they're looking at and engaged in. So I would suggest that as well. Mm-hmm. I hope I'm not overwhelming you.
No, it's good. It's all good.
This also kind of segues me to, I did go through some of your posts and looking at your hashtags.
Yes.
And so I'm going to send you a few that I would suggest, because right now, some of the hashtags are like MVP agents, MVP magic vacation planner, MVP cruising, do what you love. So especially the MVP ones, I find the ones who would, and correct me, I might be wrong on this, and forgive me if that's me just assuming, but I would think most that would be using that hashtag are probably people who work with MVP.
Yeah, those come from our main office.
Right.
So the MVP getaways, MVP cruises, MVP parks, those are the main topics within Magical Vacation Planner.
Gotcha. So someone like me who's I'm still holding on to my 30s. I'm 39. I'm hanging on in my late 30s. I'm not using those hashtags, but would I be using like hashtag family vacay, hashtag family getaway, hashtag family time, hashtag family first for my family trips when we're away? Yeah, I'd be more likely to use that. Even if I used MVP, I probably wouldn't. Like it's always like top of radar for others.
Sure.
It would be like if I post something and I put hashtag Angela S. Doyon, no one's using that hashtag but me.
Okay.
So to maximize, so three things on hashtags. One, never repeating the same like copy paste per post.
Okay.
Your hashtag should be relevant to the content, the specific content being shared, the okay. audience you're looking to work with, attract, your niche. Okay. And then, yeah, and then switching them up. So let's say if it's a Disney specific post, let's say we've got an image or a video and we've got one of the Disney characters, you know, that could be a hashtag, maybe Disney vacation, hashtag Disney Orlando or Disney California. So maybe like two or three related to what we're seeing. Some could be location based. So we could get more, like I said, like Disney Orlando is also like, okay, that's specific to that park. And then who's in it? If it's a bunch of, if it's family member, like, yeah, if it's like best friends going on a girls trip to like, okay, then we're, that's a different kind of hashtag. And then of course, speaking to, you could put a little bit about like travel life, travel addict, travel blog, because those are people who travel and they're using those hashtags and they might be likely to be following those hashtags because they relate to like their lifestyle or their industry. So just kind of having a combination. And side note, back to that kind of reference to like that reel with the little girl dressed as flounder, any kind of content you're seeing, whether it's travel, Disney, the resorts, cruises, things like that, when you come across them on your own feed, as, or if they come across on the explore page, which means they've been pushed up, I would definitely check and see, oh, what hashtags are they using as well?
Okay.
And that might just inspire a little bit like, oh, I never thought about using that one, but this one could relate to that. And you could have like a groupings, like some could be groupings of travel specific, some could be groupings of like family specific, some could be Disney specific. Even if you go into Instagram in the search bar, like if I just start typing in search Disney and I'm going to hit search and I'm going to tap the tags tab. Well, all of a sudden it's going to, in order, it's going to give me Disney, Disney World, Disney Channel, Disney Gram, Disney Princess, Disney Parks, Disney Plus, Disney Photography, Disney Love, Disney Insta. And so you can get a little bit of a Disney fan. You can get a little bit of an array of different hashtags. And now, of course, the ones that are like 15 million or 31, like Disneyland is 31.5 million uses, I wouldn't bother. But if you typed out Disneyland, let's see what else it populates for tags. Disneyland Resort only uses 1.5. Now that's a more narrowed hashtag. So that would be one specific to the California park. That might be one you want to use when you're speaking about that. So that's okay. Kind of a nice practice in terms of like looking for the right hashtags. Start to type in like that general one and it's going to show you right in there. All right, it's going to break down some other suggestions and it's going to show you how many times it's been used. So anything like above, I would say above 10 million, I mean, that's a lot to compete with, right? So having a little bit of a blend, I think would be great. And again, but then also using some travel addict, travelers of Instagram. So just a little bit of a combo there, I think would be, again, when we're looking at reach and growing following and getting more eyes on our page, that's a good strategy, okay. I would suggest.
Should I always try to use about 30 hashtags? I mean, as long as they're meeting the criteria in terms of content, audience, location, or is there a magic number to shoot for?
That's the, if I had the magic number, I think I would have the number one podcast.
So, you mean you don't?
I know, right? Not yet.
Oh, people are missing out.
A girl can dream. To be honest, like these days, I would have a better focus on the keywords in terms of search engine optimization in your caption. So really grasping like your keywords might be like, stress-free travel for families who are looking for fun and excitement, like that kind of stress-free travel, or top places to travel with kids, all-inclusive travel for kids. Things we've talked about this on another call. Yes. So if there's ways to like really niche down and keep on those keywords and then have complementary hashtags, I would rather that effort go in there.
Okay.
Just mix up the hashtags. But I think kind of best practice for hashtags, it's like, as soon as you get to the point where you're like, oh, what's another one I can add? Stop.
Okay.
Because then it's like, oh, what can I reach for? But if you've got kind of three little pillars, like, okay, what's this photo, like image, video? What do we see here? What is this related to? Is it, and then is there a location I can kind of narrow this down to? And then your niche. So you can maybe, I don't know, I would still say like the 7 to 9, but anyone listening, like that can change. Hashtags are still, for me, like, it's a mystery. Like some posts when I put 2 hashtags do great, and some they let you do 30. So I know some people have said, if they let you do 30, do 30. But if it's just throwing in a whole bunch of random hashtags or the copy paste, it's not going to help. And then of course, you know, reviewing your insights over time to see like, okay, like what content's performing well. I know we've talked a lot about repurposing. But a second to, so I guess kind of putting the cart before the horse, the hashtag strategy is definitely important. But I think when we look at it this way, because I feel like you're in a really kind of nice fresh piece with your page, rotate through like the main stuff that you know, like travel tips, strong imagery, like paint that experience of like, and engaging, right? People love to engage on Reels. You could put those polls where it's like, have a really nice background of like a cruise or a beach. And it might be like, are you a beach or are you a cruise? Or are you like, what kind of traveler are you? Like people really enjoy, it's like why quizzes do so well. Like when people are like, take this quiz, because people want to find more out about themselves. And those polls can kind of show like where everybody's sitting. And like, I love, like, especially in stories or Reels, I'm like, tap, that's the minimum effort. But it's also interesting too, from a content perspective, the more you can kind of pull your audience, where if everybody's like ding, ding, ding on cruises, we're like, well, the audience has spoken. I'm going to talk more about cruises right now, because like these people have just told me they're like into cruising. So it's like, just from, you know, kind of market research, if like I've learned that before, throwing up polls and doing a few kind of spread out, I'm like, that is so interesting. People are still asking to hear about this. I'm like, well, that's not what I was really wanting to talk about. But I'm like, you know, like, give them what they want, right? Right? So that would be another suggestion.
Okay.
I will pause there to hear, because you know me, I could just keep rambling and rambling.
Nope, it's all good. Yeah, because that's interesting, because a couple of our vendors have like Mondays, they post a special like deal of the week that lists different options. Another vendor does like a Wednesday, and I've been trying to save those and put those up just to give people some ideas. They haven't done as well as I expected. So I think I need to go back and do more of like the travel tips, the more of the experiences. Of course, when Disney has a special coming out, or Universal has a great deal, or like there's cruise season, you know, cruise season is right in the beginning of the year. So when we talk about what's coming on, you know, we'll push some of that. But maybe I really just want to start focusing more on, like you said, travel tips to become more of an authority, and also just experiences. Because, you know, you want to go to Scotland, here, let me show you what I did in Scotland last September. You want to go to London, then let me show you what I just did in London in the spring.
Yeah.
So, you know, London's great. Paris is fantastic. Here's some options and things to consider that you may not have thought about when you're planning your next trip.
And then sprinkle in the offer. Like, we need to be reminded that there's an offer here as well of like, what you offer is something you believe in and like can help people. So it's so like, there's definitely nothing wrong with sprinkling that in. But yeah, I think the experiences, and just, it's educating people. Even, I mean, I feel like, if you kind of took a little brainstorming session, you know, in the next little while, like, I think you could write down, like, here are a few pillars. One is, okay, right now, at the time of this recording, we're in July. If someone wants to go away, you know, over Christmas, what in your expertise, your expert opinion, when should they have that booked by if they want to have a good experience in terms of like getting ideal hotels? Like, that, now you're also educating in a way of like, do you know that it's important when you book out 6 months in advance, here are the benefits, or when you wait to the last minute, like, here are some of the issues you could run into. Like, that's part of, it's kind of selling, because you're like, book, I can help you. Right. But also like, you're educating, where it's like, if you're looking to go away at Christmas, and that could be like the headline on a post, like, planning your Christmas vacation, you might already be too late. And when you think like, you know, if that's coming up, if you're like, wow, like, I would suggest if I were working with someone, we should be booking this at this by this month. Like, that's education, but it's also kind of like, you know, in the caption, you can talk about why. And then if you're looking for a little bit more support, send me a DM or whatever that call to action is. And like, we can chat about like, how can we get you all planned up and like stress-free? Like that's where, you know, as people are reading like, oh, interesting, I didn't know that. And then it kind of goes into, if you need help, that's what I do. Just saying.
Okay.
Yeah. So I think.
And FYI, yeah, if you want to go away at Christmas, you really should be booked by now.
Right. So, but like, that's so interesting. But, and again, we're all in our own industries. We're like, sometimes, and I've caught myself and like friends have mentioned, or even my husband, and I'm saying something, I'm like, yeah, but like, everybody knows that. He's like, nobody knows that. He's like, you do that all the time. So yeah. Like, it's easy for you. I'm like, oh my gosh, it's so true. So with anybody who's probably like, oh, December, like the kids are still at summertime. Like, we're not even thinking where you're the expert. You're like, I've got bad news for you. And then that's where people run into higher prices. And again, that's another post, like, three reasons why booking early is going to save you money. You're going to save on your airfare. You're going to save on your hotels. You're going to save on, do you think you can get a rental car in December last minute? Probably not, especially these days. So like, also calling out the reasons why not to be working with someone who's trusted like you.
Sure.
Yeah.
All right. No, that's all great. That's all really good information. I'm glad you're recording this too, so I can go back, because I can't take notes fast enough.
Yes, come back to it anytime. And then the only other, I'll give one more thing that I had kind of in my notes, sure. And then I'll throw it back to you if you have any other questions, is the link tree. Now with MVP, yes. Do you get a page where we can learn more about you? Just for me, that was where, when I hit the link in bio, it goes to all the like forms to fill out for whichever resort or experience you're looking for. I know with Linktree, and I don't know if it's just with the paid version or if you can still do it with the free version, whichever one you have, there's usually a little bio you can add to. Would, again, like with your bio on Instagram, as well as Linktree, because like, I think there's such value in that it's you. You're like, hey, like people want to feel listened to. So if it's like, hey, I'm Marcia, like, oh my gosh, I've got three kids. I remember bringing them and I can't wait to bring my grandbaby that's on the way. Like that's human, right? And you're like, I want to make sure that you have such a great trip because I know how important it is. You work hard. You want the time with your family. Like, yes. I want to learn a little bit more of the Marcia who's like, oh yeah, I've done the Disney thing. And let me tell you through my experience, this is how to make it a good one. Because that is, it's the same thing, right? Like the way mom groups, they do so well, like those Facebook mom groups, whatever they are, because there's such power in like the community and feeling supported and heard and not. And I think that's where you can really stand out, where it's not otherwise like that. Sorry, I'm rewinding the link in bio. There's nowhere for us to be like, well, who's Marcia? And like, how can you help? But, and so I think that there's a piece there that I think could be filled for, and doing that through posts. But if there's some kind of landing page, you can create a free landing page in Canva, or if there's an opportunity through whatever, if MVP has it, where, hi, I'm Marcia, and I have like fun facts about me. I have been to da 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 da. Because again, especially travelers, like if you love traveling, you love talking about traveling, and you love talking about others about traveling. It's
absolutely
it's what we do, right? It's the same thing. Like if someone knows, I remember my husband and I went to Sonoma and Napa on our honeymoon. And we had three friends reach out, like, can you tell me your itinerary? Like, what did it? Cause it's, I'm like, yeah, sure. Like, this is, I would recommend going to this place. And like, we want to talk to people who have been there because we don't want to make mistakes when there's lots of money involved. Absolutely. And especially if there's, you know, international travel or wherever. So anyway, I think that having a personalized space where we can get to know Marcia and really connect with you in that capacity. That was just one thing I would have loved to, I would love to see that. Cause it's, I don't know if you're like me, it's like social media is our way to scope things out and investigate, where it's like, it's the same for me. Like I'm sure people come to my profile. They're like, okay, she has this, I don't know if she's the right fit. I'm gonna like stick around for a while. And then it's like, you gotta kind of, if no one's going to join my membership, if less they've like followed me around, like if I put an ad out there, no one's going to go, oh, there's a membership, I'm going to join. Doesn't happen that way. Like the people who typically, I think 90% of anybody who's like come into my community they were already following me for a while or on my email list. So I think like it's about that little nurture piece. And I think you're in a great position. Like, I didn't realize you had three kids until we were talking today. And like, that's so relatable. And like on our call earlier, we were like, my son plays baseball. Like, we have so much in common. Like, it's when people feel really connected, then, you know, that's where they want to invest their time or their dollars, where someone makes them feel like, oh yeah, like this is great. It's just comfortable. Yeah. I feel supported and heard.
No, that makes perfect sense because I've taken my kids to Disney. I've taken my kids on cruises. I've taken my children through Europe. So I can talk all about that because a lot of times people think, I think it's changing now, but way back when you didn't take your kids to Europe, that wasn't a family vacation.
Right.
But it can be, you know, it really can be. It can be wonderful. You know, cruising, people talk about cruising all the time. Cruising with kids can be a lot of fun.
Yeah.
So, you know, cruising adults only is a lot of fun too, but
I'm sure I've done both. Right.
Yes, exactly. Exactly. So just being able to sort of do the whole been there, done that. Let me tell you what I screwed up the first time and why I won't do that again.
Yeah.
Or this was great. I'll do this every time I go.
Yeah. So, we're in the same industry that way in terms of like, that's the position. That's the great position we get to be in where it's like, I've been there. I get it. I made a mistake or this really worked for me. Let me show you. And it's like, and that's where that's a great position to be in because it's honest and it's super fun. I mean, like you can tell, like I know that you enjoy what you do. And I mean, and again, like back to that word experience, like I think like, that's where I want to hear more about, like, I've been there, I've had these great experiences and like, my passion is to make sure that you do too. Like it's such Absolutely. A beautiful gift and luxury to be able to go on a holiday. And a lot of the times when people plan it, it can be really stressful because we're talking, when am I going to get the time? Is this the right time to go? How much is this going to cost? What are the unexpecteds? Like it's, and then at the end of the day, like that's a shitty way to start a vacation where you feel like, gosh, this was exhausting to plan.
Right. Right.
Your vacation is kind of like,
or you plan, you think you've got it all covered and you get there to wherever you're going and you realize, I didn't know about this. I didn't know about that. Why didn't I hear about that? I had to do this or that. And as your travel advisor, that's my job to make sure that, like I said, it's back to when you hit the ground running, you are comfortable. And Disney's exhausting. I mean, you've been there, you know that Disney's exhausting. But I love it. And there's exhausted and then there's Disney exhausted and you should be Disney exhausted when you leave because it's just an amazing experience.
Yeah.
You know, and, or even cruising, like, you know, cruising can be, it depends. And that's the other thing too, is like sometimes when you cruise, it's like, for example, to the Caribbean, it's very laid back for me. I'm not on the go, go, go. But if I'm cruising in Europe, I'm on the go, go, go or Alaska.
Yeah.
It's just, you know, it's a different mentality. And so just being able to talk to people about that and just so that, again, setting their expectations because they pay a lot of money to do this.
Yeah.
And you want to get a good value for your dollar.
Absolutely. And just feel the safety aspect of it too.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Absolutely. Well, do you have any other questions for me?
I don't. Between our call earlier and our call now, my head is spinning.
Okay.
With all good ideas, great ideas, things that I really want to go through and organize and work into my bio and in my page. I really thank you very much for
my
having
pleasure.
Me on. And
I have one last question for you.
Absolutely.
Favorite trip?
Oh, my favorite trip.
This isn't easy.
No, it's not. So probably favorite place to visit in the world would be Neuschwanstein in Bavaria, Germany.
Oh,
it's actually the castle that Walt Disney used to model the castle for Magic Kingdom.
Oh, that's so awesome.
Yes. But I would probably say my favorite trip was we did a 4-day trip to Egypt.
Oh,
completely. Wow. Yes. Completely out of the norm of what you would expect. The culture was amazing. The history was phenomenal. I do remember being in a museum and there was a mummy that was like 3,000 years old. And I just remember looking at this mummy and still some of the teeth were intact. Some of the hair was still intact.
Wow.
Thinking you walk the earth around the time of Christ, you know, just trying to put that whole piece together with history. Egypt was probably one of my most fascinating trips.
Yeah. My mother-in-law went to Egypt and she has nothing but good things to say. That's amazing. Yes.
It is. And yeah, just Egypt was probably one of the best ones. Yeah.
All right. One follow-up question.
Sure.
Where to next?
So I've got two bucket list locations that I need to get to. So all joking aside, if I can touch Antarctica and Australia, then I have visited all seven continents.
Wow. That's amazing.
Yes. So I, you know, I keep toying with more like Australia and New Zealand. That might be one of our new bucket list one locations, but I got to get to Antarctica too. Everybody That's always so says cool. why, but it's.
I will admit, I wasn't expecting you to say Antarctica, but I get it. Yeah. I mean, to be able to say that's not everybody can say that.
That's my goal. If I can die saying I've been to all seven continents, I will feel like I've succeeded.
That's so cool. I love it. We keep talking about, we're trying to figure out what we want to do next. And we've got friends who just moved to Amsterdam and we thought, oh that would be really fun. Cause then we could kind of puddle around, which is what we like to do.
Yes.
We don't like to stay put anywhere for too long. It's nice to be able to maximize. So very cool.
Amsterdam is wonderful. Where's your, so you tell me, what's your favorite trip? Your absolute favorite.
I would have to say we took our son to Italy when he was 7 months old. And I remember when we booked it, I mean, he's how old is he now? He just turned 8. So yeah, this was 7 years ago. And I remember quite a few family members were like, what are you like? Even 7 years ago, like, you're going to Italy? We're like with him, but he's so little. And you know what? It was the best experience. And he was the easiest to travel with. I mean, absolutely. He's a great little traveler now. Like I always say, for anyone who's got little ones, like start early. If you love to travel, start early. And we did 3 weeks and we flew into Florence. We rented an apartment for a week right by the Central Market. We had, you know, they had a crib, like we had it all planned out. It was great. And we could buy our own groceries. So, you know, mornings with baby, like it was just nice. We didn't have to rush anywhere. We did Siena for 5 days and then finished in Rome for 4. And it was, I'll tell you, if anybody listening, if you've got a baby, go to Italy because they love the babies. Like anywhere we went, he was a hit. He was an absolute riot. And like people were so nice to us. We were able to rent a car. It was just magical because there were logistics to it, but we went in with just grace and ease where it was like, we have everything we need and we're pretty capable. And it was, oh gosh, we still talk about that trip. We still want to go back to Italy because I would love to repeat it with him now at the age of 8 to just be like, you got it. Like he had his first pizza and his first noodle in Italy. Like that's like wow. These little milestones. I'm like, oh gosh, it was just.
Yeah. You're setting the bar really high there for future comparisons.
I mean, he's been on quite a few airplane rides and he's a great little traveler. And I think just by starting really, really young, he got really comfortable. He's like a pro at it now. So love to get back to Europe. And I mean, there's my bucket list is not nearly even a drop in it yet. So
that's fun. Yeah, that's fun. So where would be your most exotic destination or what would be your top of your bucket list?
We keep talking, we'd love to go to South Africa. That would be, that's been something we've talked about probably since our son, the year he was born. We'd love to do that. And I'd love to go to Ireland. I'd love to do the whole Ireland, Scotland, Wales, the UK. Honestly, there isn't many places that I wouldn't not want to go. We've done a lot of like wine regions, that's for sure. But I mean, I would take on any kind of experience. The world is our oyster.
Absolutely. Absolutely. One last thing I'll just say, one thing that's always amazed me, it doesn't matter what part of the world I'm in. So I grew up in a very small town.
Yeah.
I live like now I'm in Altoona, Pennsylvania. We have about 40,000 population, but I grew up in a town of about 5,000. So it's very small. And honestly, I have traveled to some of the most remote parts of the world and ran into people that knew my hometown.
It's oh, really?
Crazy. Eh? Yes. And it's not even just where I live now. It's my hometown of Portage. And that just is amazing to me.
Yeah.
So, and even I knew a girl that grew up beside my aunt. We met in the jungles of Belize. We're getting ready to zip line. And she came up because the big joke is when we travel, my husband always wears a shirt that has our hometown on it.
Oh, that's funny.
So it always starts conversations. And she came up and she asked them if it was, you know, central Pennsylvania. And he said, yeah. And she goes, oh, I grew up in Portage. And he said, so did she. Yeah.
That's wild. Yeah. It's
and
funny.
I think that's what I love about travel.
Yeah, it's funny. Anytime we've gone away, especially like when we were in Europe or down south, like people find out this is like, it's so typical, like Canadian thing that people say, oh, you're from Canada? Oh, like, so like, they just assume it's Toronto or like there's like this big, people don't, I don't think realize how big Canada is. So it's quite, I remember we were down in the Caribbean off of a cruise 1 year and this couple, I forget where they were from. I think they're from Arkansas. And they said, oh, we met two other Canadians. You gotta meet them. And it was like, cause then maybe you guys will see each other back home. It was just like, well, depends on where, but
that's funny. Oh, that's funny.
Oh, now I just want to plan a vacation.
Well, I'll help you where you want to go.
I love it. I love it. Well, we'll have to touch base if we jump in on this Amsterdam thing, because I know there's so much around it that we would want to maximize. So I'd love to chat more.
Absolutely. Sounds good. Sounds
so
good.
Remind everybody your Instagram handle, where they can connect with you. Please feel free to
absolutely
share.
Sure. It's MVP by Marcia, which it's Magical Vacation Planner by Marcia, but on Instagram it's just shortened for MVP by Marcia. You can find me on Instagram and Facebook under both.
Perfect. And I'm going to put all those details into the show notes. So if you look at a little bit more information, you want to connect, follow for some travel tips, and or absolutely, if you're planning your next vacation, I hope that this is a nice introduction to you. Thank you, Marcia. I love having this conversation. And if you have any other follow-up questions, you know where to find me.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
All right. Well, thanks so much.
All right. Thank you. Thank you. Have a great week.
Thank you so much for tuning into this episode. I really enjoyed this conversation and the opportunity to really give some feedback and get into the nitty gritty. And so if you found this helpful, I would love to hear your feedback. You're welcome to leave me a rating and review on Apple Podcasts. I'll put the link to that in the show notes, or you can always send your review or feedback right to my DMs at angela.s.doyon on Instagram. Because if you're enjoying this, then that tells me I should be creating more like this. Again, learning through conversation and discussion is really helpful. I know it's always been helpful for me, and I just genuinely love chatting with other people. So thank you for tuning in. I will be back with another episode on the Creative Marketing Show next week.